So how are we going to classify a flexible manufacturing system? So the basic classification can be whether it is designed for doing assembly operations or whether it is designed for doing the processing operations. So processing operations can be machining operations, or it can be heat treatment, or all these various individual activities. Assembly is joining of more than two components. It can be a simple joining of two or three or four components, or it can be as complex as assembling of a electronic devices like mobile phones, laptops, or other equipment. So the other classification or other type of flexible manufacturing system is based on the capability to process rotational parts. So the rotational part is a part which is produced usually by using a lathe or handling a cylindrical components. Whether the manufacturing system can handle cylindrical components. Now this aspect is very very important, because a conventional flat surface like a robotic gripper or a vise cannot grip a cylindrical component. So we require some additional provisions in the material handling equipment to manipulate or to hold cylindrical surfaces. So the entire material handling system should have some special features built into it so that it can handle cylindrical surfaces. So most of the times a flexible manufacturing system is either designed to handle rotational parts, or it is designed to handle non-rotational parts. Combination of both is usually not done because of the need of complex handling systems. So either the handling systems are designed for rotational parts, or they are designed for the non-rotational parts. So they are usually not combined except in very highly specialized conditions. Otherwise they are completely two different aspects. So the next type of flexible manufacturing systems are based on the number of machines present. So you can have single machine cell, where in the system you are having only one machine. The various parts are fed into the machine. The machining, all the processing steps are carried out in one single machine. When the part is completed, it is going to go out of the machine. So raw materials are loaded into the material handling system. The material handling system is going to move the component into the machine. The machine is going to detect, or it is going to know which component is there. Accordingly, the machining activity is going to take place. Once the activity is completed, the part will be taken out of the machine. It will go into the unloading area, and from there it will be taken out. So there are different possible configurations are there. As we can see in the figure, we can have inline configuration, we can have a rotary indexing table, we can have a carousel mechanism. So this carousel mechanism is like a loop, but it is suspended from the top by using rails and other things. We'll be discussing what is a carousel mechanism in the next few slides. So basically here you are having only one CNC machine or one manufacturing station, and you are having various work parts which are loaded on top of the pallet. Pallet is nothing but usually a flat surface on top of which you are fixing the raw material or the semi-machined part, which will go into the CNC machine or automated station, and all the activities are performed. So now if we apply the flexibility test over here, because we are using a CNC machine, there is a possibility of producing a large variety of products. Also the schedule can be changed, because if you are able to change the component on the pallet holders, different components can be manufactured as they can be moved in and out of the machine. Error recovery is not possible because there is only one machine. If this machine faces breakdown, the production is going to stop. So the minimum three requirements, all of them cannot be met. So we'll generally say that a single machine still will fail the error recovery test, but still it has got it will pass two aspects of the flexibility requirements. The next one is a new part. Yes, new parts can be manufactured if it is within the capability of the machine. Out of the four, three can be satisfied. The error recovery is not possible because there is only one machine in the system. The next one is a flexible manufacturing cell. Here there will be two or three machines. Then you are having the part feeder. The figure shows a part carousel where you are having a suspended system in which the raw materials are loaded or fed into the system. The robot will move the component from one machine to another machine. It may so happen that the two machine tools are of the same configuration but with different tools to accommodate different processes, or there may be two completely different machines. So generally speaking, a flexible manufacturing cell has got more than two machines, two or three machines, so they can produce a large variety of products. Schedules can be changed as and when required. The system can recover automatically from the error. If a machine breaks down, the robot can take out the part and load it into another machine if it is possible, and the production will not stop. New parts can be manufactured again if the part is within the reasonable variation. Next one is a flexible manufacturing system. So difference between flexible manufacturing cell and a flexible manufacturing system is the number of machines present. So definitely there will be more than three machines in this particular system, with usually a conveyor type of system to move the component from one station to another station. Parts will be loaded into the conveyor and unloaded from the conveyor at a single place, or it may be at two or three locations. Then the required processes will be completed on the different parts. The part will enter into the CNC machine and then it will exit it depending on the operations required, and as the conveyor moves, the components are going to move from one station to the other station and all the processes required will be performed. So the various machines can be of similar nature or they may be of completely different nature depending on the requirement. So the flexibility test, if we apply, part variety test is passing. So a large variety of products can be produced, schedules can be changed because we can load new components into the system depending on the new schedules. Since there are more than one machines, any malfunction is there that can be accommodated within reasonable limits. Again, that is important. Even in the previous cases, error recovery is within the reasonable limits. So the minimum three criteria are satisfied. New part test, again within the reasonable limits, any new part can be manufactured in a flexible manufacturing system. So difference between flexible manufacturing cell and flexible manufacturing system is the number of machines which are present and the way the parts are moved. Flexible manufacturing cell, a robot is going to move the components from one machine to another machine from the part carousel. So component will be taken out here, placed in the first station, then placed in the second station. It will be put back into the carousel. Again, from here the components are going to move. So in here usually a human operator will be there, or maybe a robot can also be placed over here. Components will be loaded here and then you are having the unloading which can be done over. The next type of flexible manufacturing system or classification can be based on the level of flexibility. So level of flexibility means here the variety of components that are produced. So from the graph you can see here, if you want to have large volume, then the flexibility is lesser. If you want to have more flexibility, usually the volume is going to be reduced. So if you are having a flexible manufacturing system designed for higher volumes, then usually the flexibility will be less. Then such a system is called as dedicated flexible manufacturing system. And if you are requiring very large product variety, then the annual volumes that can be manufactured will be slightly less. Such a flexible manufacturing is called as random order flexible manufacturing system. So what is the difference between the two and why there is a variation in the production volume or the annual volumes? So in case of the dedicated flexible manufacturing system, the machines are designed considering a limited set of product features or geometries that can be manufactured. So because of these limited features of the products that are considered, the machines are designed for higher efficiency. That is the reason why we are able to get higher annual volumes, but there is a limitation of the product variety. Because as you specialize machines for a particular process, the size of the components that can be accommodated will be reduced so that the activities can happen at a much faster rate. That is why we will say that as the machines are specialized for increased efficiency, the product variety that can be manufactured will be on the slightly lower end. So there you are having the dedicated flexible manufacturing system. Or is it other words, a dedicated flexible manufacturing system is designed considering a particular amount of product variety. So for that particular product variety only, the system flexible manufacturing system will be designed, the material handling system will be designed, the machines will be allotted. Now in the random order flexible manufacturing system, there is no limitation on the product variety. That is what is the assumption. Again, this is within the reasonable limits. So here we are having highly generalized machines. Even the material handling system is not designed for high efficiency. It is designed to cater to a large variety of product. Usually robots will be used so that different products sizes or shapes can be handled easily. And since the machines are not designed for high efficiency, the production rates and production volumes will be on the lower end, but you can have a large variety of products that can be manufactured.